National Stock Exchange of NSE and the National Security Depository Limited. So we have studied first of all, we have started with this. New financial institutions. New financial institutions we started with was the venture capital. Number two. We have seen venture capital, how it is formed, which are the corporations that are helping to venture capital fund, guidelines regarding that. Second, we have seen regarding the mutual funds. So, in that, we have seen the types of the mutual funds as well, advantages of the mutual fund. Next, the factoring institutions. Fourth part we are seeing is the credit rating institution. Next part is over the counter exchange. Of India. The sixth part we are going to study is the national stock exchange. So the NSE, National Stock Exchange of India, NSE was incorporated on 27 November 1992. When it was started, 27 November 1992. Under the Companies Act, under what the Companies Act and set up in November 1994. So it was also incorporated in November 1992, it's pretty similar. But under the properly it was set up. It was initiated in the 1994 for the NSE and has established trading facilities for the securities and provide a transparent market of securities for trading. You know that you can trade in the National Stock Exchange and as well as the Bombay Stock Exchange. So the National Stock Exchange was started on 27 November 1992. It was incorporated, but they started the trading from 1994 onwards from November. Why? To provide the transparent transactions to the market, they are trading here helping the customers for the trading purpose. Recognized trading members can use electronic system. The persons who are recognized, they can use the electronic systems. Trading market for NSE are selected under the provisions laid down by the SEBI. How they can function, how they can work? According to the guidelines, according to the provisions specified by the SEBI, that is Security Exchange Board of India. There is no trading floor for trading, but it is a complete screenless. So there is no, it is properly the system, it is on screenless. Matching system. Fully automated screen based trading and transparency are important aspects of trading. It is fully automated. The screens, the software are doing the things, so there is no flow, there is no user work on this, so that's why there is more transparent. Fully automated screen based trading and transparency are the important aspect of the NSE. So this is that trading is fully screen based and it is automated, so that is the important aspect, important function of the National Security Exchange of India. Automatically matched Computer trades and computer based trading are the basic features of the NSE. Thus, NSE plays an effective role in trading facilities for securities. During the year 2012, there was 1646 companies listed on this NSE. And the total turnover cash segment during the year 2012 is rupees 28,10,890 crores. Listen, till 2012, the number of companies are listed under SEBI is 1,646, and the total turnover is 2,28,10,893 crores. The total number of brokers, the brokers who are associated with this NSE, that means National Stock Exchange of India, were 1,269. So this data is regarding the level, not now. In the 7th part, National Security Depository Limited.
Depositary securities.
on behalf of the investor. Finally, institutes like institutions, banks, brokers, etc. can obtain the participants in the depository as per the guidance of the SEBI. So according to the guidance of SEBI, you can get access to the depository system. Thus in general, since depository is a place where the commodities are deposited to SEBI. So what is depository? In this depository, it is the first suggestion which helps you in the saving of your securities. For that purpose, they are helping you. So the next part. So these are even they have specified total the 7 points. Venture capital institution, mutual fund. The next part is going to be the banker institutions, both credit rating institution. Fifth is over the counter exchange of India. Next is the national stock exchange of India. Next part is depository unit in India. So these are the functions they have specified over here. Even they have specified on the table. So in that table, the growth of the dematerialization of the securities. What is the growth of that part? So here they specified. Just a minute. What amount of commissions or transferring the inevitable documents. The risk connected to the physical certificate, like or losing away, could be tax securities, theft. So this nearly is not possible. You will know the ID passwords, you can see your securities, which securities you are holding. But if you want to share it, you can request and you can see the address also. So whichever the price in the market, according to the NSE or the BSE, you can share your securities as well. Here there is no, we should not afraid regarding it will get spoiled, it will get damaged, it will get broken, it will get damaged. So these are the advantages. So in order to see, the merge user of repository expert, SEBI has compulsorily included 110 scripts of certification history done by the institutional investors. They include beside financial institutions, mutual fund, bank overseas, corporate bodies, overseas institutional investors. Slowly and gradually the number of repository participants is increasing. So the according to the guidelines by the SEBI, rules and regulations have been specified by Security Exchange Board of India. So this all repository participants should follow them. Even not in the shares in the mutual fund parts, the foreign banks, overseas corporate bodies as well, institutional investors as well. So for that purpose, SEBI is also arriving in the recent and see this thinking that is repository participants are increasing in our country. So the people can trade easily. So listen, in the table or checkup, a table also they specified that in the 1000 365 CDs they provided the services of the NSE. The CD is in 1714 till 31. This is now 2020. So the number has been increased more. So we mentioned, so we have shown the financial instruments here, we hope that we will be more useful to the student. So for that purpose, these are the further they have specified the financial instruments. How they trade, the instrument they have specified. This instrument is going to help you in the 6th semester as well. So in the short term also they can ask you, but in the 6th semester also you can you are going to study this batch of instruments, the new financial instruments. So in this, the financial instrument, the first part they explain is the commercial paper. The first part is what? The commercial paper. So in the commercial paper, what is the commercial paper? It is an instrument to raise a short-term fund. It is a short-term unsecured promissory note and issued by a large firm with a fixed maturity. It is important the short-term debts instruments in advance countries. Forms of financial position is strong. The companies having the share listed on the stock exchange are equal to issue the commercial paper. Maturity period of the commercial paper is 90 to 120 days in India. This is the short-term finance. This is the short-term, we can say that the fund, the company is raising. So the company who are listed in share market, they can even issue the commercial paper. That is a short duration from 90 to 120 days. So till we can see that around 6 months period. So it is a short term. Rating is required for the issuer from rating agencies such as the CRISIL, ICRA, Reserve Bank of India has introduced the commercial paper scheme in the money market and unsecured promissory notes fixed maturity. So the maturity is fixed. Even you know that what they say is an unsecured promissory note. This is not secured. Though the company is facing a loss, there is a risk element as well. But it is from fixed maturity, from fixed date you are getting this much money. Commercial paper are generally purchased by the unit trust, banks, and the companies of the firm having a surplus fund. Those who are having surplus fund are at the extra money in their hand, such as the unit trust, or it is a bank, or the companies, or the firm. They are going to purchase this. Issue price of the commercial paper is 5 lakh each. Issue of the commercial paper is regulated by the Reserve Bank of India. So the issue price is specified at 5 lakh and it is issued by the RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India. lend instruments. On that, the interest is decided. So now the advantages. This is quite clear, the advantages of the commercial paper. So in the advantages, the first part is commercial paper possesses high liquidity. The commercial paper possesses the high liquidity and can issue at a low cost bank, low cost than the bank finance. So here the commercial paper, this specified is the high liquidity. You can easily liquidate it at a low cost than the bank finance. So compared to bank finance, it is low, you can easily liquidate. Second, it is a short term service for finance. It is very short duration. Minimum 90, maximum 180. Surplus fund can be invested by the bank and the financial institution to develop their portfolios. So suppose I am in the extra fund, I don't want now for a short duration. So where I am going to invest? In the commercial papers. Suppose I am having the company's fund of rupees 30 lakhs as an extra. They don't require now for the period of around 6-7 months. So they are not going to keep that 30-40 lakhs as it is, they are going to be investing the commercial papers. So this is the first part, the commercial paper. Now the second part is specified is the certificate of deposit. The second part is what? The certificate of deposit. Only the scheduled bank, only the scheduled commercial bank can issue the certificate of deposit. It is negotiable for the fixed period. These are bearer certificate and the marketable receipt for the fund deposit in bank for a fixed period. The owner of the certificate receives the principal amount deposited along with the amount interest of the date of maturity of the certificate. In short, certificate of deposit are significant instrument in the money market. Certificate of deposited are negotiable instruments. Simply a receipt given to a depositor by the bank for a specific cash deposit in bank. The minimum size of the certificate deposit is 5 lakh and issued in the multiple of 1 lakh with the maturity of a 91. So it is also, we can say that short term finance, the investor who is giving the principal amount and the maturity is receiving the time. So it is a negotiable, if you want to transfer, you can transfer it easily. The duration is for 91 days to 1 year. Even the features they are specified for, 5 features they are specified. Certificate of deposit are paper issued by the commercial bank. Who issued this certificate of deposit? Commercial bank issues. So even the size of 5 lakhs in the multiples of 1 lakh. So for 5 lakhs, for that I should purchase the 5 certificate of deposits. Second, it is the receipt given to the depositor by the bank for the amount deposited to the bank. So they provide you the receipt, how much amount you have deposited. The minimum size is 5 lakhs and to be issued in a multiple of 1 lakh. So minimum I want to invest in certificate of deposit 5 lakhs, but in the multiples of 5 lakhs. This is the principal, this is the interest we are going to get in this India. In the last year, National Security Day was actually in India. So now the last part is the commercial papers. This new financial instruments. These are going to be